I'm Chirag Parikh, and I'm the senior author of this paper, Urine Tumor Necrosis Factor Alpha and Interleukin-9 for Clinical Diagnosis of Acute Interstitial Nephritis. My lab is involved in clinical phenotyping of acute kidney injury. And in this study, we looked at diagnosis and prognosis of acute interstitial nephritis, which is a common condition and a differential diagnosis of acute kidney injury in hospitalized patients. The picture on the left shows the normal kidney epithelium, and on the right is acute interstitial nephritis on biopsy, which shows tubulitis, interstitial infiltrate, and eosinophils, which are the hallmark of the disease diagnosis. The common causes of AIN include drugs, antibiotics, proton pump inhibitors, which are used for gastritis, painkillers such as NSAIDs, and autoimmune diseases. However, the diagnosis of AIN is very challenging. There is no specific symptom or sign. Renal failure is slowly progressive, and the clinical diagnosis thus is very difficult, and only half the patients present with acute increase in serum creatinine. And there is no clinical test that would differentiate AIN from other causes of acute kidney injury. And the kidney biopsy, which I told you is the gold standard, has associated risks such as bleeding and is not feasible in many patients. However, AIN is treatable. One can stop the offending agent, start steroids, and thus early diagnosis or better tools for diagnosis are sorely needed. In this study, there are three important parts which are involved in novel biomarkers development. The first part is the participant enrollment. We enrolled 200 patients prospectively who were getting kidney biopsies for acute kidney disease and created a biorepository of plasma and urine samples. Following that, to establish the gold standard, we had the renal biopsy slides, which were evaluated by three independent renal pathologists and established the gold standard for AIN versus all the other diagnoses. And the third was developing novel biomarkers and assays for them so as to identify a non-invasive method to diagnose AIN. These are our candidate biomarkers. We looked at the pathophysiology of the disease, and since 40% of the infiltrating cells are CD T cell lymphocytes, we said cytokines from the Th1, Th2, Th9, and other cytokines such as IL-6 and IL-10 may be important candidates to study to differentiate AIN from other causes of acute kidney injury. So when we developed assays and measured these biomarkers, two biomarkers stood out, which helped us separate AIN from other causes. The panel on the top shows urine TNF-α levels, which are very high in patients with AIN compared to acute tubular necrosis, which is a common differential diagnosis. And we see that in the normal patients on the right, the levels are very low. And almost undetectable. Similarly, urine IL-9 was higher in patients with AIN compared to all the other causes of kidney disease that required kidney biopsies. And we see that these biomarkers track the findings on histology, such as the levels increase with worsening interstitial infiltrate, tubulitis, and interstitial eosinophils, showing a dose response phenomena to the tissue severity with the levels in the urine. Most importantly, acute tubular injury scores on the histology were not associated with AIN, further proving that these are specific markers of immune-mediated kidney disease. When we add these biomarkers on clinical predictors, we see that there is a gain in area under the curve of about 15 points. The AUC with the clinical model is 69% versus the biomarkers, which is close to 85%, showing a significant improvement in discrimination. we can use these improved discrimination to either refute the need for the biopsy, or in cases where we are uncertain, make a strong case that the biopsy will give us a better answer. And these details are discussed in the manuscript. So in summary, we demonstrated that IL-9, which is a Th9 cytokine pathway, and from the Th9 cytokine pathway and general inflammatory cytokine TNF-α were higher in AIN than non-AIN in all analysis. This shows that the Th9, IL-9 mast cells may be a key pathway activated in AIN, and we should study this further for mechanistic reasons. And all the other cytokines from Th1 and Th2 pathway were comparable between AIN and controls. Interestingly, this disease is limited to the kidney, and no other plasma biomarkers were different in AIN versus other causes. And overall, our findings suggest that the urine biomarkers improve discrimination and will add to clinical utility for this condition. Thank you.